Hello everybody and welcome to Luxury Benefits channel. My name is Vyatoslav and today we will talk about book as eyes trainer and top 10 rules of reading and how to read books correctly. Book as eye trainer. Reading is one of the greatest pleasures given to us for a reason. For me personally, a book is one of the best ways to relax. But any printed text is also a serious burden on human eyes and brain. We are not naturally created to perceive information through certain characters. To understand what the mark or some sticks, strokes or circles you need to extract from your memory while learn ideas about the meaning of certain combinations of various symbols. The brain needs to correlate these symbols in memory with letters, then a combination of letters with words, words with object that they mean. Finally, you need to choose the correct definition from the context and even add an impression of all of this. The work of comprehending the text is a serious burden on our memory, imagination, brain, psyche, and of course eyes. Therefore, each person who cares about the health of their eyes should know the rules of reading, writing, and other visual work performed at close range. These rules are not clearly stated anywhere. From different manuals, we learn only about the importance of highly controversial provisions about lighting and a certain distance from the eyes to the text. Rule suggested here I had to collect bit by bit from various sources. Good reading rules. Rule 1. We need to perform palming or any other exercise on relaxation, giving a short rest to the eyes before reading, during reading time, and as a feeling of eyes fatigue. These rules prepare the eyes for visual work. Especially if you come from a job where you've been dealing with numbers all day or work at the computer screen, don't grab a book or a newspaper. Sit 3 to 5 minutes with your eyes closed, rest, and then let your eyes work. Tired? Put the book down, wash your eyes, say good words to them. Do bear wiggles exercise by the window or some other relaxation exercise. If you don't want to lose not a minute, you can wash the dishes or do something at home. In order not to forget about the need for palming in the process reading, you can put bookmarks with tips in the book. For example, such palming urgently needs to be done. Eyes will be very happy. Rule number 2. Use blindfolds on one eye or pirate glasses when reading. When reading with two eyes, both muscle works and some mental stress. This is due to the fact that different eyes can see the same thing in a different ways. Combine two different images and it's more difficult for them to find a single meaning than in situation where the brain only one image arrive. In addition, one eye always rests in a blindfold, but only from visual perception. All muscle actions perform open eye synchronously repeats the closed eye. This is why it's so important so that the bandage is comfortable and doesn't interfere with blinking and movements of the eye. Rule number 3. Periodically change the posture and distance from the eyes to text. We already know this rule. I will only remind you of the need maintaining a straight line between the back of the head, neck and spine. And remember that long reading or writing at the same distance leads to spasm of the oculomotor muscle. The eyes are losing the ability to refocus and therefore the ability to see clearly images in the distance. The easiest way is to change the pause or move the text away from you when turning the page. Rule number 4. Look into the distance at first in each paragraph. This recommendation is a continuation of the previous rule that teach us to change distances. Only in this case, the change in distances occurs not by changing the posture, but by frequently shifting the page to various objects in the field of view. At first, deliberately take your eyes off the text, then you can do this refocusing automatically. If there are very long paragraphs in the text, look into the distance through every 4 to 5 sentences. Select paintings as a distant objects, object in a window, a flower, so that your gaze is directed only objects that are pleasing to the eyes. Rule 5. Blink lightly and often, at first, at each point or comma if the text consists of long sentences. We have already talked about the great benefits of blinking. Moisturizing and protecting eyes, blinking allows us to get a tiny time to rest. Moreover, this will not affect the quality of perception and reading speed, and the eyes, they will get tired much less and will serve you much longer. Rule number 6. Read aloud daily with expression at least 10 to 15 minutes. The simple rules hides a lot of meaning and a huge benefit. Firstly, during these 10 to 15 minutes, you can simultaneously practice the simple reading skills described above. Constantly remember to blink, refocus, and change distance at first as become difficult. But for 10 to 15 minutes, our attention can be kept on this. In addition, reading aloud itself activates not only visual, but also auditory perception. We hear and control through the brain the correctness, pronunciation, stress placement, maintaining correct intonation and expressiveness when reading. At the same time, our speech, diction, articulation are trained and respiratory rhythms, and this increases blood circulation in muscles of the face and strengthens the vocal cords. I was amazed to learn that 80 small facial expressions are used to pronounce the word "ooh" muscle. In addition, reading aloud give us confidence that we don't delay breathing. As it's sometimes the case when reading all sorts of horrors to oneself and scary scenes in crime dramas and detective novels. But the main thing is that through speech a significant aid to vision is provided. By the way, why when reading aloud to children it looks natural? I think that when reading something interesting out loud to a loved one gives extra warmth to a relationship. Rule number 7. Play a kind of a breaking game from time to time, ears, nose, clap. This is very rewarding and fun exercise that you can try to execute right now. Touch with two fingers with your right hand to the right ear and with two fingers of the left hand to the tip of the nose. Clap your hands and then change hands. Touch the right to the tip of the nose, left to the left ear. Repeat several times, then do the exercise crosswise. With your left hand, touch the right ear and right hand, left ear. How is it? Lost your nose or grab two ears at once? Train. This exercise develops coordination and will greatly enhance perception. The point is that as soon as we make unusual, non-stereotypical movements, instantly neural connections between the right and left hemispheres are activated and a certain brain gymnastics is performed. For the same purpose, you can tap your belly with your right hand and tapping lightly on the head with your left hand and then change hands. Or draw a circle with one hand and a square with the other. or just write different numbers with different hands. Very complicated but useful and fun process for training our brain hemispheres, neural connection and memory. Rule 8. Conduct sessions of prolonged breathing regularly. Inhale through your nose, leaning back slightly, and then exhale slowly through slightly pursed lips, tilting your body slightly forward. 3 to 4 such breaths are enough for the depth of visual perception. Enlarge and the eyes read what had looked blurry before. A powerful flow of oxygen plays a role here, which is so essential for our brain and eyes during visual work. Exactly, lack of oxygen in most cases becomes the cause of deterioration of vision, especially in old age. As claimed by more than 100 years ago, the famous American doctor Paul Bragg. Rule number 9. Do not read immediately after meals and immediately before sleep. This recommendation seems to me one of the most difficult to do. When, if not after eating or before going to bed, using these legal moments of rest. Some people say that they cannot fall asleep without book. What happens to us after eating? Blood flows actively to the organs, the gastrointestinal tract, and the brain controls the correctness of digestion process. And the more abundant we ate, the more internal forces go to us for this lesson. Doing visual work also powerfully activates resources. Brain, mind, memory, imagination. Combining these two processes, text perception and digestion, leads to heavy load on the body. However, more often than not, an overeating person is simply not able to read a serious text for a long time. He will either fall asleep or feel pain in eyes and put down the book. A painless transition from dining table to writing is possible if you eat lightly and correctly. What are the dangers of reading before bed? Do you remember that at the moment of reading, a special mechanism for the perception of written speech symbols is turned on? If you fall asleep with a book in our hands, then this mechanism not turned off, and the eyes continue to strain for a long time meaningless, even if you cannot sleep without a book. Learn the correct transition from one state to another. For example, if you put off book, make turns, thumbs or fingers, and then cover on a few minutes with the palms your eyes, then completely remove the tension from the eyes. It is best to repeat positive thoughts to yourself during such palming. This will switch the eyes to mode for good rest, deep sleep and easy waking up in the morning. Rule number 10. Rest after every 40 to 50 minutes of reading or another visual work. This rule can be called another law of good vision. Law this one applies to all kinds of eye strain. It is no coincidence that many enterprises, especially with conveyor system, it is customary to give workers 10 minutes of rest every hour. It has been proven that if you don't, labor productivity drops sharply, injuries increase, and the quality of work decreases. More waste is done. Thanks for watching this video to the end. Today we learn how to use book for eyes training purposes and about top 10 rules how to read properly. I hope it will help you. Subscribe to my channel and we'll see you again.